Hi everyone, I hope you all are doing well. This is Radhika here again, and this video is going to be about why empaths get obsessed, and it will cover a little bit of the twin flame dynamic which a lot of people I see are facing now, or at least I see that in my clients, and also a solution to this obsessiveness that comes with this dynamic. So first, at an energetic level, we can see what is an obsession. Okay, so obsession is a very strong word. If you kind of lessen it in intensity, what it means is a want, you know, like when you have a want for something or a need. Even if you make it more intense, it's like if you have a need for something, and then when the need becomes even more intense, then that turns into like an obsession for something, or you know, which obsession has like an addictive quality. So it's like I need it to, it goes into like a survivalistic fabric when you say obsession for something. So basically, if you just reduce the intensity of obsession, what the obsession turns out to be is it's like a want, that you want something in your life. And that's a very normal thing, because human beings, as they are, they always have wants and needs for things. And most of the time, these wants and things are first for survivalistic purposes, but later on, what these needs and wants become is basically these are the things that will make this human being feel whole or feel complete inside themselves. And basically, when you feel completely whole and complete inside yourself, you are closer to the goal of self-realization. And that is the goal of everyone's life, whether you know it or not, whether you're aware of it or not. Whatever action you do in your life is ultimately taking you towards that goal of self-realization. That is basically the reason you get obsessed with something or someone, is because you need a certain energy that object or the person gives you, which makes you feel complete, which makes you feel whole. And that's why the obsession first begins, because at an energetic level, you are attracted towards something that is going to take you to the next stage of your evolution. And this obsession can actually look very negative on the outside. So a lot of people, they get addicted, or addictions are a form of obsession. So they get addicted to some material thing, like they'll get addicted to drugs or alcohol or porn or gambling or something like that, which is extremely addictive in nature because it gives you a high at the end of it. So basically what you do is you're chasing that high so the high that you get is basically the energy that makes you feel whole, that makes you feel complete, that makes you feel connected to something. And that is why you keep going back to that substance again and again. And so basically what you're chasing after is the end goal, is the end feeling. And sometimes these addictions or obsessions could also look almost like healthy on the outside. So things like people who are always working, people who are always busy, people who always have some plan, people who shop a lot, like shopping, or always the need to do something and the need to do something to perfection. All these things are also actually obsessions, but they might look healthy, or they might seem like more acceptable on the outside because you see so many people doing them. So it's quite normalized in society to do these things. But if you go deeper into it, actually these are also obsessions that a human being is kind of dealing with. So these are some kinds of obsessions or addictions, and the one that I get asked about the most is obsessions with another human being. And this can play out in the empath narcissistic dynamic, where you know two people get into a relationship, one is extremely selfless, extremely giving, and the other one is kind of avoidant, or they are more holding back their feelings or love or care, etc. So in this case what happens is it creates like an addiction with the other person. So even in this case, the addiction is with the person's energy, you know, what the other person has that you lack in that dynamic. So basically all these things that I spoke about right now are extremely common. Even like everything, if done in moderation, is not actually bad for any human being. The problem becomes when it becomes excessive, it becomes like an addiction or an obsession. And that is why addictions or obsessions happen, because when a human being is not able to understand why this obsession or addiction is happening, they don't understand that what they need to do is they need to imbibe this energy into themselves. Then the obsession keeps growing and growing and growing, because the human is not understanding the point of it. And the point of it is, it's not the object of your obsession that you are obsessed with, it is the result that you get from that object. And I mean, I'm also categorizing humans as an object of addiction or obsession in this case, which is kind of wrong, but I'm just doing it for the sake of the video. So it's the energy that you get from that, whatever you are addicted with. So that is what you need in your life. And so basically the twin flame dynamic is such a dynamic where there's a polarization between the two people. So I'll just give you some examples. So in the twin flame dynamic, what happens is two people who are polar opposites but who need to kind of imbibe some of the qualities from the other person come in contact with each other. And it creates like such a dynamic that there's a lot of push and pull energy, kind of like a narcissist and empath. And it happens because the person who, like, I'll just give you an example. So say there is a woman who is extremely like career focused and has a lot of plans and goals, etc. in life. And she meets like this man who is very like, go with the flow, he doesn't give a damn, and he's very like, he doesn't care about his finances, etc. So now what happens is when they meet, there's an immediate dislike at a logical level, because this woman at a logical level is very like career oriented, etc. So she will want to associate with people who are like her at a logical level, because at the logical level she thinks that is what will take her in the direction that she wants to go. But at the energy level, what the energy body is trying to do is it's trying to integrate every energy into your energy body which you lack. So at the energy level, the woman lacks like this easygoing attitude and I don't give a damn attitude, or you know, I don't care about finances, I'm not materialistic, etc. So at the energy level, she is attracting this person, but at the logical level, she is pushing this person away. So this creates like a dichotomy of sorts between this, in this dynamic, because there's a lot of push and pull here, and one person is more active on the logical level and the other person is more active on the energetic level. So at the energetic level you feel a certain way from this person, but at the logical level you feel a certain, you see their actions to be something totally different. So it creates a sense of confusion, and this basically happens because the person, like the woman who's very oriented in her career, needs to have a little easygoing, let go attitude for her to feel wholeness within her being, for her to feel whole and complete and satisfied, and so that she has imbibed all the energies in her energy body. And the man who is like really easygoing, etc., maybe he needs a little bit of structure in his life. He needs a little bit of more caring about your finances, taking care of yourself, taking, you know, building more in the material realm, etc. So that is what creates this twin flame dynamic. It can happen between any two people. Actually, it's not just like a male-female dynamic. You can have it with multiple people. It's only like, it's only because in the male-female dynamic, you really feel it, because the polarization is very high. So you really feel the polarization. And when both of them are feeling it, you are actually connecting at a very high psychic level. Both the twin flames are kind of connecting and energetically transferring between each other. So in a narcissistic and empathic dynamic, I'm not talking about malignant narcissism here. I'm talking about general narcissism, and not like in an extreme abusive situation. I'm talking in a generic situation, and I get a lot of clients like that who are not in very extreme situations. So I'm just talking about those situations. What you can do to kind of end this dynamic, or if you don't want to be a part of it, is you have to kind of sit down and list the things that you judge in the other person. So if you're an empath and you're the other person is more on the narcissistic side of the spectrum, what you have to see is what are some of the qualities of that person that you really admire. So it could be that you really admire their attitude of having very strong boundaries, or it could be that you admire their attitude of not caring all the time. You know, maybe it's to you, at a logical level, it will feel very difficult to like someone who doesn't care, because you feel like indifference is not good. You should always care, you should always help other people, you should always be there for other people. But energetically, your being is trying to integrate all energies. So even if you're a very caring person in your personality that you are, or your ego that you're carrying, at a soul level, your soul also wants to integrate this part of you which is not caring, which is indifferent, which is like, I don't care, you figure it out for yourself, or you help yourself, you know, that kind of an attitude which you see in this person and you admire at a very 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 soul level, not a logical level. So that is what you have to integrate, and the narcissistic person has to integrate this feeling of caring for other people, or for trusting other people, or for giving a damn about other people. So you obviously cannot do the work for the other person in the relationship. They have to do their own work. But if you are the empath in the relationship, then what you have to do is you have to sit and you have to see what are the qualities that you judged in them. And those qualities that you actually judged in them are the ones that you want to integrate in your being. So if they criticize other people, you have to realize that you are not beyond that. You have also gossiped in your life. You have also criticized other people in their life. If they laugh at other people and you feel like that's not a good thing to do, then you need to remember there were times in your life where you have laughed at other people. So whatever we judge in the other is something that needs to be integrated within ourselves. So that's the first thing you can do. And then the second thing you can do is you can also kind of understand their energy and come to terms with yourself that you actually like it. So when you agree, when you come to terms that you actually, there are things in this person that I admire, that's the time the ego that is in resistance to this person, because you have a part of your ego is in resistance to the energy that this person is carrying, you have to dissolve that part of the ego because it's building a resistance in you. It's not helping you become whole. So you have to let go of this resistance. And I'm not saying you have to go and marry the person. You don't have to do that actually. You don't even have to talk to the person. This is all done at a very mental and energetic level. So you don't even have to tell that person ever that you did it. You just do it so that you get out of this dynamic of push and pull with this person. And what they do then in their life is up to them. If you get out of this dynamic, they will probably find someone else who is still, if they don't do the work, they will find someone else who triggers the same feelings in them. And then they will become like twin flame. I mean, they will get into the twin flame dynamic with that person. So yeah, I think that covers it. Basically, every obsession that you have with an object or a person or an idea or anything in life is basically pointing you to something that you need, to an energy that you need to integrate in your life. And that's the whole twin flame dynamic, which is pretty big right now. So yeah, that was this video. I hope this helps you in some way, and thank you so much for liking, commenting and subscribing to this channel. I wish you all a lot of love and a lot of light. Thank you. Bye.